If you like my videos, don't forget to follow me on social media to keep up to date with all the latest news regarding my channel and my content. And most importantly, don't forget to subscribe below or at the end of the video. Don't forget to check out my Amazon store, filled with recommendations on Blu-rays, DVDs, books, and other media featured in my videos. G'day guys, Dave Lee coming at you once again from Down Under. We're back here at... oh no, there's no shop sign near me. We're back at the shops anyway. Heading back to JB Hi-Fi, of course. Today, we're not doing a big Blu-ray haul. We're heading in to check out one title, and that is, of course, Thor Ragnarok, which has been released on Blu-ray, Blu-ray 3D, 4K, Steelbook, DVD, all the bells and whistles. This Wednesday, it's coming out officially, but we have lax embargo laws here, so we release everything early on a Monday. So we're gonna head in, we're gonna check out all the different versions of Thor Ragnarok that are available in Australia, and I'm gonna hopefully pick up the Steelbook version for myself. We'll go home and do like an unboxing thing. I picked up the 4K and the 3D from the UK already, so we'll do like a big unboxing thing where I'll like do a comparison between the Steelbook, the 3D, the 4K and all that kind of stuff. So let's go to JB, let's hopefully get that Steelbook. All right, so that's it. We checked out JB Hi-Fi and had a look at all the different versions of Thor available here in Australia, of course. Pretty bare bones, no slip covers, nothing like that. And really expensive prices too. We'll talk about that in a minute. Really, really bugs me. But I did manage to pick up the one thing that I wanted, which was the Steelbook. There are only two copies sitting there on the shelves. I don't know if they had any more ready to go up on shelves or anything, but look, if you're after this Steelbook and you haven't pre-ordered or anything, I suggest rush out and like get it as quickly as you can. As I said, only two in my store that I could see anyway. I was lucky to be able to get mine today. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go home, we're gonna take a look at the Steelbook for Thor Ragnarok, and we'll take a look at the 3D and the 4K editions from the UK as well, just to give a little broad spectrum of what's available out there. Let's go and do it right now. All right, here it is. This is what we've all come for, the Thor Ragnarok Steelbook. Of course, I picked this up at JB Hi-Fi here in Australia. This is also available through Zavvi in the UK and through Best Buy in the United States. Doesn't come with a 3D or the 4K like the UK or the US Steelbooks. It's just bare bones. It's got one disc and it hurts a little bit because it's a $40 disc, which was exactly the same price as buying either the 3D or the 4K edition of this movie. Makes me a little bit annoyed when they throw in all the bells and whistles in the overseas editions, but then here in Australia, we have to pay the same price as a 4K or 3D disc just for the standard Blu-ray. It's a little bit annoying. At least throw the 3D in there or something. Give us something with this. But you know what? I'm used to that by now. And the fact is, I'm always going to end up buying a 3D and a 4K edition anyway, because I want them in the little slip covers. And this Steelbook is just a bit of a novelty. So it just annoys me for those people out there who really only want to buy one edition of these movies. Let's just get into this and have a look. I'm really excited. It looks really nice. Your magnet. All right, so as we can see, the title here is actually on this J card, which is slipped on the back, and of course, all the information and stuff is just printed on this cardboard J card sleeve sort of thing on the back. So let's take that off firstly. Oh, that's actually interesting. There's a title on the slipcover itself, which we don't often get, so that's nice. As we can see on this, there's actually no embossing, which is strange. Usually they have a little bit of embossing on the title, or a little bit here, or whatever. There's actually none on that. If we get a little bit of a light on there, we can see there's kind of a little bit of a metallic shimmer on there, which is pretty cool. But yeah, nothing in the way of embossing on this. Let's flip this one around, and on the back, we've got Thor's helmet there, which is some pretty cool artwork. I really like that, actually. Of course, no embossing. There's never any embossing on the back covers anyway. Pretty cool, I like that. If we open it up, That's actually really nice. There's some really nice artwork on this. I actually like what they've chosen. Would have been cool to get maybe the artwork of the Hulk on the back or something like that. You know, they did this whole poster series in this style. It'd be nice to get the Hulk on the back or something, but I still think that's pretty nice. And you will notice that there is a title on the spine of this one instead of all the character faces down the spine, which Disney tended to do for a little while until people started complaining. And now they've put the title of the movie on the spine there too. Let's flip it around and open it up. Of course, we get no pamphlets or anything in here because this is an Australian Disney release we're talking about. We don't get digital copies or anything anymore. It's just one standard Blu-ray, not even a DVD or anything. And there you go, that's the artwork. I think that's pretty cool. They've chosen a really nice piece of artwork to go in the middle there. Very stock standard. You got the standard Disney blue disc with white writing, which is a little bit annoying. I wish they'd put some effort into putting pictures on the Blu-ray discs, but you know, we've had to deal with this for about 6 or 7 years now, so nothing unexpected. So there you go, there's the Thor Ragnarok Steelbook. Looks really, really nice. Actually, like, this is one of the better Steelbooks. I was really disappointed with the one they did for Guardians of the Galaxy 2. It was terrible. Probably the worst one they've done. But this is a really nice one. I like the artwork they've chosen for it. Of course, again, over in the UK and the US, there are versions which got little bells and whistles on them. There's 3D editions, there's 4K editions. Now let's take a look at these two cool editions they brought out in the UK. We have the 4K edition here and the 3D edition here. First up, we'll take a look at the 4K set here. This is a really nice set here. We've got a lot of embossing on the cover here. Get a nice close up of that there so you can really appreciate all the embossing that is on that case right there. I think that's fantastic. As you'll notice on these UK slip covers here too from Disney, it's the full slip. It's like goes top to bottom. It doesn't have those annoying little cutouts at the top and bottom that the US sets have. I don't know why they do that, but yeah, that's really nice for those who hate those little cutouts. Now we'll take a look at the 3D cover here. How cool is this? This is one of the best covers I've seen Disney do ever, and it's really surprising that this is a UK set. Usually the UK sets don't have as nice packaging as the US ones, but this is awesome. Look at that. We'll get a nice close-up of this. I can't even explain this. I can't even explain what this is. It's like it's almost like a lenticular kind of feel, but it's not lenticular. It's like this really cool sort of design on there. That is fantastic. That was actually a nice little surprise when I opened that up in the mail, because I wasn't expecting something really nice like that, especially from the UK sets, which in the past have just been like flat, matte, boring. This is really, really cool. There's just a little look at the back covers of those two editions here. They've all got exactly the same special features and stuff. The only difference is the 3D one comes with a 3D disc and a Blu-ray. The 4K one comes with a 4K disc and a Blu-ray. All the special features are exactly the same. Likewise, this is the back of the Steelbook. They all use pretty much the exact same artwork sort of there, but it's all moved around and all different. Again, the Australian one actually has all the same special features and everything as these two as well. Crack this 3D one open. It's exactly the same artwork as on the slipcover itself. We have got two boring discs there, blue with like a silvery writing on there. No pictures or anything. Really, really boring. 4K one right here. Exactly the same front and back. We've got a picture on the 4K disc, which is nice. They're putting a little bit of effort into the presentation of their 4K disc. I guess I want to sell more of them. And they've got the standard blue with white text on this Blu-ray, which kind of strikes me weird, because then you've got blue with silver here. It's like they have done two separate pressings of that Blu-ray for both of the sets, which is, it's odd. You'd imagine they'd just do one pressing and then they'd include the same disc in both sets, but there you go. Other than the way the print is on the disc, it's exactly the same. And there we have it. There are the three really nice editions I picked up of Thor Ragnarok. 4K, 3D once again, available in Australia and the UK. These are the UK sets because I really like the packaging. The Steelbook is available just about everywhere around the world. There's different versions of this. Once again, if you want to check out the video that I did about all the different Thor Ragnarok versions that are out there, you can click that little link up the top in your screen there. Otherwise, you can check that out at the end of the video. Okay, once again, those are the three awesome editions of Thor Ragnarok I've picked up on Blu-ray. There's a ton of versions available right now. This is the first time in just about ever I've not actually opted for a US disc of a Disney movie. Usually I do, but I'm finding it so hard, so expensive to import from the US now. And I just really, really love the artwork that they were offering over in the UK for Thor Ragnarok. And once again, of course, to add to my collection, I had to get the Steelbook, which is fantastic. If you're in Australia, you can pick this up up from JB Hi-Fi right now. Again, that price, $40, such a bitter pill. Awfully overpriced for a standard Blu-ray. Again, you can pick up the 4K and the 3D for this price, which is really annoying. What I will say is, if you do happen to buy Thor Ragnarok at JB Hi-Fi, they're giving out these little vouchers with it, which is, thank you for your purchase of Thor Ragnarok. You're now entitled to 20% off the ticketed price of Justice League upon release. Seems the only way they're able to sell these DC movies is to give away a voucher with a Marvel movie. Look guys, I'm gonna wrap this up. I hope you enjoyed this video. If this is the first time you've watched one of my videos, you've enjoyed it, and you'd like to see more like this in the future, then please hit that big old subscribe button at the end of the video to give me a little bit of support. To all my regular viewers out there, thank you once again for joining me. To absolutely everybody out there, don't forget to hit that like button down below. It does a great deal in getting my videos out there. Look guys, I hope I'll see you all again soon. Until next time though, take care, and I hope you have a marvelous day.